One of the most important functions in physics is the delta function. Even though the delta function isn't even a real function in the usual sense. So, what is this delta function and how can we deal with it? That is what you will learn in this video. First of all, we take a look at our phi of x, which is just a Gaussian e to the power minus 1/2 x squared, and we add this factor 1 over the square root of 2 pi in order to normalize it. So integral from minus infinity to infinity equals 1. This is the red curve over here. Now we have a very small peak. Now we can make the peak much bigger by adding an epsilon. So if we define phi epsilon of x, what do? We use as our argument x over epsilon instead of x, where epsilon is small, so this is going to make a very narrow peak. And in order to normalize, we divide by epsilon, so we still have this integral 1. And then we get this function over here. So what we get is a function which is everywhere very, very small and it peaks around 0, but has still integral equal to 1. So what's interesting about this type of functions? Well, let's take a look. So we have our phi epsilon of x over here, now written down explicitly. So what happens if you take some other function f of x, multiply with phi epsilon of x, and then we integrate from minus infinity to infinity. And now we take epsilon very, very small, very, very narrow. So this function is phi epsilon is now 0 almost everywhere. So this this integral, the only contribution you get is if you're very close to 0. So you can approximate your f of x by f of 0 as a constant and take it in front. And then you see this integral is normalized, so this integral equals 1. So what you get then, if you multiply f with phi epsilon integrate, you get a function value at 0, if epsilon is very much smaller than 1. So more formally, this is approximately equal, of course, and it is equal in the limit for epsilon to 0. So if you take epsilon smaller and smaller, you will get closer and closer to the value f0 if you compute this integral. So what does this integral do? What does phi epsilon do? It picks out from f of x exactly the value at 0. And that is what a delta function delta x does. So if you have some function f of x, you multiply with the delta function and you integrate from minus infinity to infinity. What the delta function does, it picks out exactly the value of f at 0. So what would happen if you would plot it? What would happen if you make this graph over here, taking epsilon smaller and smaller? Well, you get the peak gets higher and higher, and becomes the width becomes smaller and smaller, and a zero everywhere else. So in the limit, epsilon to 0, what you get is 0 everywhere, except at 0, where your function is infinite, in order still to normalize it. So that's why the delta function is not really a function, because a function cannot be infinite. Now, a more general delta function is a delta function with argument x minus x naught. So what does that do? Instead of the contribution of f at 0, it picks out the contribution of f at x naught. You can see this, for example, using a substitution rule or whatever. So that gives you the f of x naught. Now, what does this delta function do on function f? It kind of acts as an identity with respect to the convolution. Because see what happens if you take the convolution of f of x with the delta function. Well, you know how to do that. Take f of xi, delta x minus xi, integrate with respect to xi from minus infinity to infinity. Now you know what the delta function does. Picks out the f where this x min xi equals 0. So that means xi equals x, so you get f of x. So what does the delta function do? If you take the convolution of f with the delta function, you get f back. So so the delta function acts as an identity, as a 1, with respect to the convolution, and as an identity, and as phi. And that is why this phi epsilon is called an approximation to this identity, because what it does is if you take the limit epsilon to 0, then this phi epsilon approaches delta function, acts as an identity on f, and gives you the f of x. So that's what a delta function is. That's why it is sort of an identity. And that's why phi epsilon is called an approximation to this identity.